Hello everybody, welcome back to another Blender Made Easy video. Today we're not in Blender, we're in Photoshop, and I'm going to be showing you how to create a painting color effect with a black and white image. This is pretty simple, and we're just going to be using a couple of mask and adjustment layers to get this effect. The first thing that we're going to be doing is cutting out this brush right here. So select your pen tool and make sure it's set to path and not shape or it won't work. And then zoom in here with the zoom tool by pressing Z, and then just go around your brush just like this. And all the links are in the description, so it's really easy to get these. They're just off Pixabay. Alright, so go download them and then come in here and start doing this. Alright, this is a pretty easy mask. It's not too hard. All we have to do is just come over here, and then this part is a little tricky, but I'll show you guys what to do. So when you get up here, just go around like this. Alright, it's not too hard, just kind of select around all the little things sticking out, just like this. Alright, good. Connect it. There we go. Okay, so once you've done that, zoom out and then right click with your pen tool selected and click make selection right there, and that should make a selection. And then all we're going to do is click this little button right here, and that makes it a mask just like that. That's awesome. Okay, so zoom in here, and as you can see with our selection, it added some tan right there and it doesn't look that great. How we fix this is by selecting it first. So control left click over the mask layer, come over to select and mask right there, and then make sure this part is selected, this little, what is this called, let me see, it is called the redefine edge brush, so make sure that is selected. And then just first click on the red part and then click on all the other tan parts, just there we go. And my computer is a little bit slow right now, but take your time, go all the way around. There we go. Once it's all selected, come down here to the output, click new layer with layer mask, and click OK. That should output it as a layer mask. And then, as you can see, it did a pretty good job of getting rid of all the tan, and that's good. Apply this mask layer, and then click V to select the Move tool, and bring it over into this part over here. Awesome. Alright, now we're going to focus on the girl, so you can hide this layer, and then select the background. The first thing that we're going to be doing is adding a brightness contrast node to give it a little bit more of a contrast. Alright? So brightness contrast, bring this down to negative 49, and then press tab and go 48 on the contrast. Alright, the next thing that we're going to be adding is a hue saturation node. Click there. Set the hue to negative 5, the saturation to negative 49, and the hue or the blackness to negative 9. Then select this thing again and go black and white. And then we're going to set this one, the red, to 65, the yellow to 117, the green to 62. We can leave all the others except the magenta, bring that one all the way down. Perfect. And then click the little X. The last adjustment layer that we're going to be adding is another hue saturation node. Alright, so hue saturation, set the hue to 8 and the saturation to negative 33, and we'll just leave it at that. We'll be grabbing these later. But I want to deselect the eyes. I want to make them with color. So select your black and white layer mask and zoom in into the eyes. Select the brush and then just paint with the black. Make sure the black is selected and then just paint over the eye. There we go. That's it right there. And then over there. Perfect. Then I'm going to come over on this side and do the exact same thing. So just painting over, it gives the eyes some color, which I think is really cool. There we go. And then hold Alt and then drag it into the hue saturation and then click Replace Layer Mask. And then it will make sure that this doesn't bring the saturation down. All right. So there we go. Oh, also, I forgot to add, I need to do a curves. So click here and click, where's it at? Curves. And then I'm just going to bring this one down just a little bit, and then this one up just a little bit. Like that. I think that gives it a nice, cool look from there to there. Very cool. Maybe the opacity, just bring it down just a tad. Like that. Awesome. So that is done for now. We'll go back to it in just a little bit. Unhide the brush tool, and we're going to be focusing on this. So the first thing that I'm going to do is place it over on the cheek. So press Control T. Make sure it's selected. Then press Control T. Rotate it. Scale it down just a little, and then place it right there. You don't have to place it right where I'm doing it, just wherever you would like. Something, how does that look? Yeah, that's fine right there. I think that's good. And now I'm going to add a hue saturation node. So hue saturation, make sure it's clipped to this or it's gonna affect the entire thing. Set this to colorize and set it to 14. Then the saturation to 22. There we go, just like that. Now I'm going to add another hue saturation node. All right, hue saturation. I'm going to set the saturation all the way down and make sure it's clipped right there. Then unselect that. And then the last thing I'm going to add is a brightness contrast node. So brightness contrast. Set the brightness to 101 and the contrast to 32. And then make sure it's clipped. There we go. And then just bring the opacity down just a little bit. Yeah, that's good right there. All right, I want to make sure this is selected, and I'm just going to select around this, the brush itself. All right, so just select around the brush, just like that, going all the way around, and then boom, that's all you have to do. Right click, make selection, okay, and then select your brush tool and make sure the mask is selected, then paint black over top. There we go. The next thing that we're going to be doing is painting the cheek. So select the black and white layer mask right here and then just paint over the cheek. Just right about there. Looks good. Bring it up. You can do as much as you want. I'm going to go something like this. Let me see how that looks. That's a little too much over on this side. So, wait, wrong one. You can press X to switch between the two colors. Just, there we go. Wrong one. How does that look? I think that looks pretty good. And I know this has some brush strokes, and we're going to fix that in just a second. I think that's exactly what I want. Yeah. Very cool. Alright, so now I'm going to select the brush tool, come over here, and I'm going to select this one. If you don't see that, try hitting this little settings and click reset brushes, and then it should be right there. And then I'm going to select this and turn off shape to dynamics and scattering. That should do it. And now we're just going to start painting, just like this. Just go over it. There we go. Something like that is fine. And for some reason, I don't know why, but every time I switch, I turn on and make sure it's white, and then I go like that, and it deletes it, And then I go black and it does the same thing. And I'm on the layer mask. I don't know what the heck's going on. So we'll fix that in a second. Just paint it like this. There we go. So it kind of looks like a brush stroke. And then zoom in and grab a regular brush. Make sure the hardness is pretty low. And then just kind of paint over it like this. There we go. So now we got like brush strokes right there. So that looks pretty good. Okay, and then also it looks like this has some red right there. I don't really want that. So I'm going to select the black and white, grab a brush, and then just take it out. The next thing that we're going to be doing is adding a shadow underneath the brush. So click new layer, zoom in here, and select a regular brush with a soft edge, and then just paint black. Make sure this is underneath, and then paint black right there. Very cool. And then come up here, maybe a little bit black, zoom out, and then bring the opacity down. Then we're going to add a blur effect to it. So go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, bring it up, and click OK. There we go. Awesome. Alright, so there is it. There is our image with a painting color effect. I think it looks pretty cool. I hope you guys liked it. I hope you made something cool with it. If you did your own thing, make sure to tweet it to me or leave it in the comments down below. I'll be happy to look. Alright, but that's going to be it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Goodbye.